This is a special news bulletin with Stephen Ritz, live from the Bronx, New York.
Assalamu alaikum and hello, Abu Dhabi International Book Fair. I'm excited to be coming to you from New York, all the way to you in Abu Dhabi, and bringing my message of passion, purpose, and hope to you, and give you a little background about my work with Green Bronx Machine, the two books I've written, the book that I'm working on, and my ongoing love affair with the United Arab Emirates. Although I can't be with you today, no, I am counting the days until my feet are in the sand and I'm walking with you on the Corniche, visiting the Grand Mosque, admiring the Royal Palace, enjoying myself at Waterworld, hitting the Al Ain Oasis, seeing the snow at Jebel Jais, and also visiting the Camel Souk, where I promised to put my cheese hat on the head of a camel. 5 short years ago, I was a top 10 finalist in the Global Teacher Prize, picking me right out of the South Bronx and putting me right in the heart of UAE, where I fell in love with all of you, the culture, the commitment to innovation and technology, and all of the Emirates. To think that my work has been featured on the cover of Teach Middle East magazine, the Gulf, UAE National, and countless other magazines and publications is really one of the most humbling things. And for that, I say shukran. For those of you who don't know, I'm a teacher, I'm an urban farmer, I'm an innovator, and I had this vision of growing food and innovation in classrooms. A little bit of my work can be seen in this short video right here.
This is our skyline. These are our shops, our supermarkets, our windows, our doors, our homes, and our yards in the poorest congressional district in America. This is our soil. Here, we are growing something greater for children who love to learn, to make, to nurture, and to taste. This is Green Bronx Machine.
Remarkably, that work caught the attention of KHDA and Dr. Abdullah Al-Karam, who invited me to present at What Works, and there I received a standing ovation, and from then on, it was game on across the Emirates for me. I started visiting schools, teachers, universities, businesses, and realized that together we could grow something greater. And that's why today I'm so proud to call UAE my second home. And I yearn as I'm standing here in front of you to feel the sands of the desert underneath my feet, because I've learned all about the desert through the amazing work with my brother, the Green Sheikh. And as we speak, the Green Sheikh and I are working on a book which we hope to debut in 2021 called Bringing the Farm to the Desert, a book about health, wellness, nutrition, culture, sharing, and making sure that children and adults understand that we need to steward ourselves and our planet to a better place, and that together we live in a world of impossible less.
Stephen Ritz and myself as the Green Sheikh, we're not just building friendship and understanding, we're just beyond sustainability and building real a model that can light the world.
My friendship with His Highness the Green Sheikh shows that two people can come together from the most disparate backgrounds, but that which brings us together is far greater than the differences that separate people, and therein is a lesson for the world.
This year, my work with the Green Sheikh has gone on to a whole new level. In fact, I was proud to take a sand bath in the middle of the desert, and the pictures and the story have literally gone viral. Imagine being buried up to your ears in sand in the middle of the desert. One of the most transformational moments of my life. Our work at Green Bronx Machine has been featured in media around the world, but one of my proudest moments is when my students and I were invited to the Obama White House, where we put a garden both inside and outside the White House, and we were featured at South by South Lawn, where President Obama highlighted our work as being on the cutting edge of combating climate change in National Geographic magazine. To think that we even have a replica of my classroom in in the Bronx in the U.S. Botanic Garden is awesome sauce. In 2011, I stood in front of the White House listening to Mrs. Obama speak about the way we treat our children as being indicative of who we are as a nation. And remarkably, back then, this is how big I was. So to think that I've lost over 100 pounds and have eaten myself to good health, I take great pride in being a role model for students and teachers, both here in the States and across all of UAE. And then to actually get to meet Ms. Obama herself, OMG, it was the recipe for awesome sauce. Our work has gone on to achieve acclaim everywhere. It all started with a TED Talk that's now had over 1 million views. I've gone on to meet the likes of Richard Branson, Deepak Chopra, Oprah Winfrey, and I was even invited to the Vatican to meet Pope Francis himself. How cool is that? Perhaps my luckiest break of all was meeting Waleed Abushakra, chairman of the board of ESOL Education, an internationally acclaimed network of private schools, including many all across the Emirates. And today, I'm proud to be faculty at ESOL Education as the Director of Health, Wellness, and Innovation for all of ESOL Education, with my home office being Fairgreen International School in the Sustainable City, where we have children growing, learning, and creating new paradigms for healthy living and 21st century technology. I'm proud to see the children of Dunecrest American School and Fairgreen International School growing food indoors using our Tower Garden technology. I couldn't be more excited that the Green Bronx Machine curriculum is now available in Arabic and is being used in schools all across the Gulf. And whether you have one tower garden in a classroom, multiple towers in a classroom, or are growing on a commercial farm using this amazing technology, the amount of food you can grow is astronomical. This is not Photoshop. This is 24 days on a rooftop farm. We're not working harder, we're working smarter and using less water, less resources, and so much less space. This is the recipe for awesome sauce. I'm proud to have a Tower Garden farm located in the Sustainable City. And as we speak, we're shipping Tower Gardens to schools interested in using our Green Bronx Machine curriculum. And nothing is more exciting than the work that I will be doing with the Green Sheikh when we start building farms all across the Emirates. All of that led me to partner with KHDA so that we could teach students, teachers, and families how to make healthy eating fun. Realize, with the COVID crisis, we now have the time on our hands to really make healthy eating fun. To take the time to try new foods and cultivate a smarter and more sustainable palate. Plates and meals like these are exciting. They're fun to make and also they're family oriented. So take the time to learn how to make healthy eating fun and enjoyable for you and your family. This is your moment. I got so excited that I decided to write this book, The Power of a Plant, highlighting my odyssey across the green revolution and my personal weight loss. And no one could be more honored than me that Dr. Abdullah Al-Karam himself wrote a foreword, an acknowledgement for the book. This book has been blurbed by 45 celebrities, including the likes of Deepak Chopra, Marion Nestle, Nona Evans, Daniel Lubitsky, Tom Colicchio, and so many more. It became a number one bestseller and got me invited to Emirates Literature Fest, where I was delighted to again visit schools all across the UAE. From Emirates Festival of Literature, I wound up meeting my dear friend Sally Musa of Pulse 95, becoming a regular on her radio show. And it was then I decided that I wanted children all across the Emirates to learn how to make it happen, and wrote this children's book called Make It Happen in multiple grade levels so that children across the UAE and around the world could learn what I did, how they can make it happen, and how they can grow something greater in their life as well. I'm so proud because this book features all kinds of skills for success. It teaches children how to ask for help, has all sorts of useful tips on how to grow a garden, how to cook a recipe, how to start a club. The contents include my own early life, the first steps of a journey, overcoming obstacles, concepts around teamwork, my current career, my career spotlights, and defining moments. It has critical depth of knowledge questions and encourages students and teachers to bring nature into your classrooms. It has a glossary, internet links, a bibliography, an index, pictures from across UAE, and so, so, so much more. I'm proud to chronicle my relationships with celebrities, Dr. Abdullah Al-Karam, Waleed Abu-Shakra, Ferris Saeed, and so many more in this book, so children can learn that they have the power within themselves to grow something great. I was proud to debut this book at the Sharjah Book Authority and the Sharjah Children's Festival of Literature and visit even more schools from one end of the Emirates to the other. And nothing brings me more joy than getting out, shaking hands with children, inspiring teachers, inspiring healthy living, and inspiring healthy learning for everyone across the Emirates with my crazy cheese hat and my bow tie. To visit my dear friends at GEMS Modern Academy and have a hero's welcome is a tribute to the students in spirit all across the UAE, and I am forever grateful. I can't wait to come and visit you and your schools too. The past 18 months have literally been nonstop for me as Green Bronx Machine continues to expand across the United States and around the world. Just last year, we finished filming a Project Explorer episode, and believe it or not, it debuted on Emirates Airlines. Imagine 35,000 feet up in the air flying to visit UAE and seeing my students and I on the back of a chair in Emirates Airline. Here's a clip.
This is so simple, but so elegant.
You know what else is pretty cool about these towers?
It takes less space.
It takes less space. And what does New York City have none of?
Space.
But they grow so much.
They're really practical and efficient. There are about maybe 25 of us in total. All of you could get a full bag of food from this amount of space and what we grow.
In fact, here is what TV star Carrie Byron had to say.
These tower gardens are brilliant.
It was so awesome to have her visit our classroom in the Bronx.
The more programs like this there are, the more of a difference there is.
And you can see the rest on our Green Bronx Machine website.
In 2018, our PBS special, Growing a Greener World, episode 808, went on to win a world-coveted Emmy Award, the first in the history of the New York City Department of Education, and yet another notch on the belt for Green Bronx Machine.
I'm proud to be using Tower Garden technology with my little Princes and Princesses, which by the way was one of my favorite children's books. And you can see in this video how cool and how easy it is to grow so much food in such little space using 90% less water, 90% less space all year long. No sooner than I returned home from UAE, I was off to Chicago, where we have over 60 schools using our Green Bronx Machine curriculum. Some of the amazing results of our program can be seen in pictures like this, in partnership with Jonathan Taves and the Chicago Blackhawks. No sooner than I came home, we were featured on WPIX-TV and visited by the Brooklyn Borough President, who gave us this amazing citation and had this to say about our program.
When you do things like this, you're not only teaching young people how to eat well, you're also teaching behavioral practices, and you're showing them how fun it is. Steve and his Green Bronx Machine is going to turn into a Green New York City machine. This is what education is about.
And as we speak, we're finishing up a full-length feature documentary all about Green Bronx Machine, our curriculum, and the work that we are doing all around the world, which I hope to bring to the Emirates in early 2021. I'm so proud and honored to be with you today, and even though we are apart, I can feel the world coming together. And that is the power of the Abu Dhabi International Book Fair, the power of words, of people, of ideas, and of literature so that we can share and imagine and reimagine a bigger, better, and brighter future for all of us. Remember, readers are leaders, authors change lives, and teachers change lives.
I believe all of us have a story to tell and that our stories are our ladders to success. Now more than ever, the power of literature and sharing books brings families, people, and cultures together. They are sacred. And I'm so grateful to the Abu Dhabi International Book Fair to highlight me and this group of amazing authors, stories, books, and literary geniuses designed to inspire and empower all of us at this very critical time. Shukran, shukran, shukran. I'm honored to be a North Star of passion, purpose, hope, and positivity for all of you and for all that is possible around health, wellness, nutrition, and growing something greater. And know that no one is more excited than I am to join you in Abu Dhabi soon with my green shoes and camel socks to get out there and make epic happen. So from the bottom of my heart to your homes, I say thank you, shukran. God bless you. My name is Steve Ritz, and I'll see you soon. Make epic happen.